Hello, we've got the barbecue out today because there's an ever-increasing trend for outdoor cooking. And last year, the UK became the largest market within Europe with a massive £7 billion spent on outdoor cooking. We've got some beautiful cuts of meat here. We've got a beef sirloin steak, a bonus pork loin steak, and a classic lamb chop. And we're going to show you some simple tips and tricks of how to get these on and off the barbecue for maximum effect. Season the meats and oil them to make sure that they don't stick to the cooking grates. These are a good 20 mil thickness, a nice little standard thickness. Just brush some oil onto here, and I'm using vegetable oil, not olive oil. Olive oil will burn at the high temperatures that we're using on the barbecue. So we use the vegetable oil because it will keep the meats nice and flavorful. So a little bit of vegetable oil on both sides. We've done with that. And then a liberal, nice little season with some flaked sea salt. Bit of cracked black pepper, and then we turn them over. We want to make sure that both sides are oiled and seasoned. These steaks have also been out of the fridge for about 20 minutes. This just takes a chill off, and it also helps them to cook more evenly when they go onto the barbecue. If the meat's more supple, the heat can get into the center more evenly, and it will mean that they cook quicker, keeping them juicier, more tender, and you get a better consistent product. So move over to the grill. We've got the sirloin going on, the pork steak, and the lamb chop. These are all going to cook at different times, but we'll take them off as and when they're ready. We put the lid down. This will help prevent flare-up. When you have the lid open, the fats that drip through the grate will have too much oxygen and they will create flame, and then your food's overcooked on the outside before it's cooked through into the center. So we close the lid. That will reduce the oxygen. Any fats that drip through will just turn to smoke, and you'll get a beautiful barbecue flavor. Any dishes that we do on the barbecue can easily be transferred to the kitchen, so don't worry if you don't have a barbecue. The same tips apply in your kitchen as well. So the steaks have all had a couple of minutes now, and we're going to check that they're ready to turn over. A really simple way to know that they're ready to turn over is when they don't stick to the cooking grate. As long as we've oiled both sides, the steak should turn over nice and easily when we try and lift them off with our tongs. And what's happening here is that the sugars in the protein will caramelize as they're in contact with the cooking grate. When the sugars have caramelized enough, you'll form your char marks, which will actively separate the meat from the cooking grate. We've given them a couple of minutes on the second side, and now it's time to check the beef sirloin especially. The simplest and most accurate way to make sure that they're cooked but not overcooked is to use a digital thermometer like this one. And we just take the tip of the probe and we pop it into the center of the steak. For a medium steak, we're looking around about 60 degrees. So this one is cooked, and I'm happy to take this off. For pink lamb, I'm looking for around about 60 degrees C. Feel free to do your pork steak to medium in the same way that you would cook beef. And for that, it's the tip of the probe into the center of the pork, and it's 60 degrees C. A couple of moments have passed and our meats are gonna be rested, so it's time for the moment of truth. So we'll slice into this beautiful bit of beef sirloin. Look at that, nice and juicy, nice little bit of pinkness. Really, really happy with that one. Next for the pork, we're looking here for the meat to be nice and cooked through, but again, nice and juicy, not overcooked, keeping the flavors in the meat. And finally for our lamb, hopefully a nice little bit of pink lamb. Look at that, nice little bit of pink lamb every time, 60 degrees, no problem. So we've shown you some tips. We've talked through the different products, the beef, the pork, and the lamb. We hope these tips are useful, and we hope that they'll let your customers get the most out of the meat that they buy from you and cook on their barbecues.